Welcome to our Highland studio and this Masterworks oil painting reveal, in which we take you through the process of creating the low road. From my Spirit of the Highlands collection. This painting brings me considerable joy, for it captures many memories, depicting a scene that has since become changed forever. Not long after making the Northern Highlands of Scotland our home, the low road to Dornoch quickly became one of our favourite routes. In common with many, we love to take this single track with passing places that meanders along past farms and stone cottages set snugly into banks, carpeted with bluebells in summer and ablaze with bracken in winter. On it goes, past Camore Woods and the Lochans, until you round the bend and there is your first view of the town, with its skyline broken by the spire of Dornoch Cathedral and the turrets of the Dornoch Castle Hotel. Every time we drove to Dornoch, I was inspired by the light and colour when rounding the bend, and I was determined to capture this. For something else used to also greet the drivers, cyclists and walkers that wended their way along the low road. A solitary tree with its trunk leaning away from the prevailing easterly wind blowing off the North Sea, its lovely rounded crown catching the light of day. We had no idea that this view would soon be a memory, the iconic tree destined to be uprooted, to make way for changes in the offing, its status lost forever, as is the original view. All was not lost, however, and I was able to continue with the painting, with the tree restored to its rightful place, standing as I remember it. This is where taking reference notes, sketches, and photographs come into their own. Visit the fine art section of my official website, artworkshopwithpaul.com, to see this painting and a selection of other original masterworks in my original paintings gallery. Thankfully, I had plenty of reference material, so work could continue as planned on what has become a significant, poignant composition. So here we have the very starting point of the low road. You'll see in the top thumbnail, the composition is broken down into three main elements. There's a triangle on the left-hand side, which is the road disappearing into the distance. This is important because it gives us great depth. It's a simple one-point perspective, but that really carries our eye into the distance. To the right of that is a triangle, which is a field full of snow. Within that field is the tree. In the distance, we have the town itself, and that's a horizontal element. Within that is the two distinct shapes of the spire of the cathedral and the castle hotel. They are really distinctive, and they break into the shape of the sky. As soon as I put that down, I realised that it left an awful lot of sky without a great deal of interest. I wasn't really interested in putting a complex sky in this. I was interested in all the textures of the snow and that distant landscape of the town itself and the tree. So below that you'll see how I evolved that really into something which worked much better for me. You can see now that the distant town is much closer to the top of the painting. The negative space of the sky is much more interesting now. It jigsaws shapes, if you like, around those two elements and also around the trees. We still have the triangle of the road on the left-hand side, but it's just a little bit smaller to make sure that the gate, which opens up onto the field, is just a little bit closer and is a little bit more important in the composition. That triangle of the field is now slightly altered by the gate shape intruding into it. And the tree, which was very important to me, you can see plays a much more important part. So as soon as I'd really accomplished that, I decided that that really worked for me. And in fact, that's quite a fast resolution for me as far as thumbnails are concerned. But it answered all of the things that I required for this particular composition. Watch more free to view behind the scenes videos on the Fine Art video page in the Fine Art section of my official website, artworkshopwithpaul.com. Throughout the ever-changing seasons of the year, I delight in what they have to bring. Here, a winter scene which features dry, crackling leaves of copper beech hedging, stone walls draped with snow, ubiquitous broom thrusting its way through tumble-down fencing, and a bright blue sky stretching as far as the eye can see. The scene is bathed in that low, warm light which gives such form to the landscape here in the Scottish Highlands, creating a wonderful contrast against the deepest ice-cold shadows. The Low Road is available as a limited edition fundraising print in aid of Macmillan Cancer Support. To read more about this subject and its significance, and about our three fundraising prints in aid of Macmillan Cancer Support, visit the limited edition prints gallery in our official website, www.artworkshopwithpaul.com. My long acquired knowledge of traditional techniques and how to exploit them is essential when working on a painting such as this, which requires the build-up of many layers, gradually working through from the darkest recesses to the lightest sparkling highlights. Layering is essential. It allows the initial build-up of texture using directional brushstrokes of impasto, that's thick paint, through to the finer, thinned-down mixes of glazes and tints. There is absolutely no rushing this process. It requires meticulous attention and considerable patience, for the overall result has to be reassessed along every step on this journey of discovery. This is what makes painting particularly exciting for me, and especially so in using traditional techniques. Do you paint? Would you like to learn these traditional techniques? Browse through our extensive catalogue of video tutorials, as listed in our Art Workshop with Paul tutorials page on my official website. Welcome to Series 2 of Masterclass in Oils with Paul Taggart. The subject of this masterclass is reflecting on open bay. Let me now take you to the painting so that you can see what you will get from watching this masterclass from start to finish. This painting is about midsummer, about the green light moving through the background and also the shimmers of the water across the foreground of the painting. What excited me about it was the way the light varied all the way down this vertical composition, moving from light to dark in an S shape from the greens of the hillside through the water right into the foreground. While these rhythms of light were entrancing as seen from the other side of the bay, it wasn't until the yellow fishing boat came into view that I knew that I had my focal point, the wonderful yellow glow that this gave as the sun reflected from its hull was really exciting. And so it became one of the central motifs. And from that, I began to concentrate this particular masterclass on the details of that yellow boat and all of the other elements along the quayside. So let me invite you to look over my shoulder. As first of all, I deal with those wonderful greens of midsummer, as the sunlight really shapes and forms the trees. You will then see how I deal with the buildings. Buildings can be incredibly exciting subjects because they too capture the light in exciting ways. The shadow side of the buildings create a contrast for the shimmering light. Just look at the way the light falls across the lifeboat station. It's wonderfully bright on the right-hand side where it's sunlit. The yellow light really shines out here. But in the shadow, it's exciting too. There are blues and yellows to find within these shadow areas. And then we have those shimmering lights across the roof, picking out the architectural details in the light. Let's move slightly over to the right, where we have an area of pink flowers. And here we have the light catching in a totally different way. The texture breaks up the light, but the contrast of the light against those dark shadows is of absolute importance. Here we have a contrast of texture, but we have a contrast of value, and also a contrast of hues, because those pink colours against the green really do vibrate. Here we get light created in quite a different fashion. I do spend some time creating these miniature figures within the painting. Although they are tiny within the composition as a whole, they do perform an incredibly important role. Even seen from a distance, the eye focuses on these particular figures and it gives the painting life, it gives scale. They are wonderfully lit against bright light behind them. They have light falling down their right hand side, and yet they're quite dark little silhouettes. So it really is worth the time seeing how these particular elements of the painting are nurtured and brought forward against the light. As always, we send you best wishes from Eileen and myself.